Hi, Jesus Professor here, and in this episode of Prophecy 101, we're talking about recognizing divination. Not everyone has the gift of discerning of spirits, or the kind of visual revelation gifts where we can quickly see the snakes in the spirit realm. Yet, we're all called to test revelation, hold on to the good, and reject the evil. The spirit of divination has been around for a long time and knows how to fool Christians. Likewise, Christians who work under the spirit of divination for years or decades have also learned how to keep their ministries afloat without contradicting scripture very often in ways that are obvious. Yet, when growing in the gift of prophecy and testing, we need to do better than our personal discomforts and dislikes. Here, we zoom out and consider a person's life and ministry as a whole to recognize the spirit of divination in one's body of work instead of by obvious errors in a single purported prophecy.
Cling to the Father and His holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train.
As in all areas of testing prophecy, prayer and searching the scriptures are key. Two things that are easy to spot regarding the spirit of divination are a life that still shows significant lack of self-control and an obvious profit motive. Does the ministry promise people freedom that the ministers themselves don't have? Does it seem like creating and maintaining revenue streams is a higher priority than speaking God's word in truth? Does the ministry seem unwilling to speak words in cases where there might be a direct negative impact on their revenue? A mature prophetic ministry that is speaking for the Lord will over time have a fairly even distribution of prophetic words between reminding their audience of promises and blessings of covenant with God and Jesus, and on the other side, reminders about covenant requirements and warnings about sin. Warnings about sin will include the specific sins that are occurring in an audience, whether or not they are known through natural means. Since a lot of sin is hidden, there will be occasions where the sin was not broadly known before the prophecy brought it into the light. The more sin that comes to light many years later, but was never spoken to by the purported prophetic voices, the greater that provides evidence for the spirit of divination at work in these ministries. The Holy Spirit is not silent about unrepentant sin. If the prophetic ministries are asking, seeking, and knocking for revelation, the Holy Spirit will be speaking about it. But the spirit of divination is speaking also. Suppose there's a widespread porn problem with men in the church. After the Holy Spirit reveals this at some level in private to some gifted people, then the spirit of divination will move to suppress appropriate preaching or follow-up investigation or prophesying, and the spirit of divination does this by making predictions of trouble. Divination portrays preaching to and exposing sin like opening a Pandora's box. Divination predicts that confronting sin will bring division in the church and reduced giving and volunteering. The spirit of fear becomes a second voice in the heart, emphasizing possible consequences rather than righteousness. Over time, the net effect is for a ministry to be easily unbalanced toward promises and blessings with inadequate treatment of covenant requirements and warnings about sin. Ministries heavily influenced by a spirit of divination often have some words with impressive accuracy, but they can go for years without speaking to serious ongoing sins among their leaders and the people on the stage. A second imbalance that gives evidence of a strong influence of divination is a much higher percentage of messages aimed at the lay Christians, the foot soldiers in God's kingdom, rather than the leaders and the institutions themselves. Scripture tells us that judgment begins with the house of God, and those who purport to be teachers will be judged more strictly. Yet, the spirit of divination will predict trouble for someone when they receive a negative word from the Lord for leaders and institutions. Many prophetic ministries depend on recommendations and a good reputation from leaders and institutions because these recommendations are necessary for ministry opportunities and earning potential. If they prophesy about sin much at all, it's simply less risky to be nonspecific and to refuse to speak words exposing or speaking to sins of Christian leaders and institutions, especially leaders and institutions in their own denomination or movement. Instead, if they speak to institutions at all, they pick safe targets, like more progressive groups on the opposite side of major social issues like LGBT, or groups on the opposite side of major evangelical debates like the Reformed movement, women in ministry, or charismatic gifts. If a prophetic ministry only speaks negative words for ministries that they'd never receive a monetary check from anyway, then it's evidence that the spirit of divination is effectively suppressing negative words for ministries they work with more closely. Shout Jesus from the mountains, and Jesus in the street. Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name.
There's a long black train coming down the line.
Hey man, how's it going?
I've messed everything up. Flunked out of school, my girl dumped me, no one wants to hire me because the drug thing.
Feeding off the souls that are lost and crying.
You ask Jesus for help?
What's the point? Maybe it's time to unburden everyone from my crap.
A year ago, I was like a deer in the headlights. Whenever I wondered if a friend was contemplating suicide, my ministry training had not prepared me to handle these crisis encounters. Then I took a suicide prevention course from E94 with Justin Pallison. This 90-minute course taught us how to recognize the warning signs, gently ask some direct questions, persuade people in crisis not to take irreversible actions, and confidently refer them to one of the free and widely available resources to move them from crisis to lasting recovery. Justin is a qualified, gifted, and skilled teacher. He's the right man at the right time to bring this training to you and your church. This training is free and can be provided in person in North Georgia, and virtual training is available anywhere in the world. Visit their website at e94.org for more information.
Cling to the Father and His